And to having started off something, an idea, to having germinated from a college project to actually culminate into a book. Now, I'd like to know, what was the first thought that came across your mind when you knew that you wanted to probably just get on to the entire process of making this into a book? And when that happened and when the book was out, of course, in the initial stages when a lot of the people you knew got to read the book, if they did, that is, what was the kind of feedback that you got?
So initially, when we submitted the project, we got a lot of appreciation. A lot of people told us the concept is brilliant. Why don't you convert this into a book? And we were like, we said no. I mean, are you kidding us? We three teenagers. Do you want us to go and get a book published? And it seemed like a completely illogical idea. But then we started thinking. We actually thought about it. We thought maybe not. We had like discussions. We had like midnight teleconferences. And then we decided to why not try our luck. And since HarperCollins publishes these kind of books, you know, on the city, we said let's take a chance. And that's what we did, and we got really lucky, and the feedback has been amazing. I think before our launch, people were talking about the book. Like, our Facebook page had over 3,000 likes before today. Today is when we're officially launching the book. So it's thanks to like family, friends, and all our well-wishers who've really, really, you know, contributed to the success of our book even before its launch.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much, Priya. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our guest here, Miss Malini, who's going to be releasing the book. Thank you so much for being here, Malini.
So one of the things I think that is probably needed for your next edition is something about Mumbai traffic, because all the words that went through my mind on the way here today. But I wanted to tell you guys, congratulations. This is such a cute book. It's so much fun. And I was just talking to Mike, who's my manager, and we were discussing how it's a great souvenir for anyone who comes to Mumbai, or you have friends visiting and family, you want to take it back, and people ask you, you know, what's Mumbai like? And it's really like everything that says in this book in a little capsule. But I had some questions for you as well when I was going through it. So how did you pick the words, and did you sit around one day and just write them on a chalkboard? Or?
I remember our... A professor telling us about this college project we have to do, and all three of us, we were sitting together in class, and we remember like coming up with this idea, and immediately like in class right there, you know, we started jotting down words, you know, we started making this whole long list of words which are Bombay, and it came so naturally to us, so that's how.
And I see there's a lot of pictures, and I snuck a peek, and some of them have your own credits. Did you go take the pictures? And there's some drawings as well. So did you spend one day running around Bombay taking pictures?
More than one day.
Yeah, I'm sure.
A lot of days, but...
And what are your... I'm going to ask each of you, what is your favorite phrase from this book? Which one is your one favorite one? And then I'll tell you mine.
Okay. To start off with mine is Dinchak. Because I think everything in the city is over the top, right? From the page 3 parties to even the small gully celebrations that happen in the city. So because of that, I feel Dinchak is the word that describes the city in its totality.
Absolutely.
Okay, mine would be cutting chai, like right now cover everything, but yet it's not like one of the hidden words. But yes, because every experience I've had in Bombay, like cutting chai has been so much a part of it. Like so during college, in between lectures, cutting chai is what we would have. Even while I was working at Better Photography, most of our editor meetings and team meetings would happen at the tapri downstairs over a cup of cutting chai. Then I would when I'd go shooting around the city in the hot sun, which happened a lot thanks to this book and because of my passion for photography as well. So cutting chai is something that would always keep me going. So yeah, so I'm not a tea lover, but this is the only kind of tea I can die for.
Now what about you?
Right, so if I had to pick one favoritely, absolutely your favorite word, it would be Ayla. I love this word. It was a great, great term. It was great fun illustrating it, writing it, and simply because the scope of this word is so immense. I mean, Ayla can be a mark of surprise, or it can be a mark of absolute disgust, or just like a casual interjection which you insert into a conversation. So it's almost like a multi-purpose word of sorts. So yeah, Ayla would be my favorite word.
Are you also an Aamir Khan fan? No, just checking. Mine, actually, I was going through it, and there's so many that I love. Page 3, obviously, is mostly what my life is about. But I love Horn Okay Please, because one, you see it so much that it's sort of ingrained in a memory. And I don't know how many people listen to the radio here for many years, but I used to do a show called Horn Okay Please on Go 92.5 many, many years ago. And I like that it's such a great phrase, Horn Okay Please, because it's still so polite, right? That's what I love, you know? All my friends who are from abroad and other countries, they say, what is it about India that's special? I think it's, and hopefully all the parents here will agree, that we have respect and we're polite. So even in that situation, we say please. And there's another one for your next book, which my husband actually told me, there's for your information, they always write FYI, but here so many people say FYIP, it's for your information, please. Which is quite sweet. So tell me, what are your plans next? Are you gonna do another series? I was just saying the next one, and I hope somebody from HarperCollins is listening, do a pop-up book. It would be so much fun if this was a pop-up book. Tell me about your new plans, next plans.
We've been asked by a lot of people to write books on their cities. So we've been getting a lot of requests to do a book on, say, Delhi or Kolkata or any of that. As of now, we're happy to have this book with us. And we're just enjoying the moment as of now. I mean, that is pretty much. And yeah, we'll see how things go for us.
I also think it would be really fun for everyone if you picked one of the words at random and read out a little bit of the passage since you've written it that way. You look very shocked. You wrote this book, you'll be fine.
So let's pick the favorites, among the favorites. So which is one, Jakas or Dimag?
Yeah, why don't we take favorites from the audience? It's a great idea. Any favorites?
Any favorites that you'd like to read out?
Okay, we'll tell you what some of the options are and then you can pick.
We've actually already done that.
Oh, great. Okay, great.
So I think let's start off with Jakas. Okay, so if something's good or really good, a simple jakas can convey your sentiments. Meaning excellent, jakas is the city's favorite compliment. Doled out generously, it effectively captures sentiments of admiration and awe. So if you think the girl next door is looking particularly lovely, tell her she's looking jakas. The new super hit Bollywood movie is Jakas. As is Western Railway's spanking new train service or the local Bailwala's signature dish. To add impact, team it up with an all-Indian gesture for excellent. Unlike most English compliments, which have degrees of comparison, jakas has no degrees or derivatives. It's either jakas or it's not.